Hello everyone, welcome back to another Star Wars Destiny video. Today Fantasy Flight released several more spoilers across a few Star Wars Destiny community sites. And we're going to be discussing those spoilers now. So some of those community sites were Tiny Grimes, The Chance Cube, and the Jedi Trials podcast. They all spoiled some cards today, so I'm just going to go through the cards that were spoiled there. First up, we have Slave One. A yellow villain support vehicle, costs 4 resources, has a 2 range damage side, 3 range damage side, 4 range damage for a resource, a special, and a blank. And the special is force an opponent to deal damage to their characters equal to the number of dice in their dice pool, distributed as they wish. So if they have 6 dice in their pool, you play the special, and they take 6 damage. If they can split it up, but if they only have 1 character left, that character is going to take 6 damage. This is pretty interesting. I really like this card. I like that it also costs 4, so it's not as expensive as something like the AT-ST. But I really like the special. I also like its damage side. So 3 pretty strong damage sides, especially the 4 damage for 1 resource is pretty good. I also like if you use Cunning, you can trigger a special on Slave 1, and if you have Slave 1 still in your pool, and even though it's on a different side, you can then also trigger damage off of it as well. So you Cunning into the special, and then you either roll your Slave 1, or if it's already there, let's say it's sitting on the 4 damage, you can pay a resource and do 4 more damage. The special can be pretty devastating, especially if people are leaving dice in their pool to, you know, focus into later, or they're trying to pull off planned explosion. So let's say they're rolling dice, trying to get it to be 10, the value to be 10 or more, and then you can just, let's say they have 6 or 7 dice in their pool, just blast them for 6 or 7 damage. They get to split it up however they want, but like I said, if they're only on, if they're down to 1 character, that character is going to take all that damage. Shields will block the damage though, so it's not unblockable damage, but it's still a ton of damage. This is going to be really interesting. I would like to have it possibly, I could probably build a Jango deck around it as well, because it's Jango ship and then it becomes Boba Fett ship. The damage sides are good, the cost is pretty good too, and especially with some of the other cards we're going to show, this card could be really strong, especially with that special. So we're going to move into our next card. Alright, and our next card that was spoiled today was Snap Wexley, Red Hero, has 8 health, comes in at either 9 or 12 points depending on how many dice you want to run. He has an interesting die as well, so he has a 1 range damage, 1 disrupt, 2 disrupt, 1 discard, 1 resource and a blank, and his ability is really cool, really interesting as well. So while at least one of this die is in your pool, your opponent must spend 1 resource in order to claim the battlefield. That's very controlly and pretty cool, especially considering he has 2 disrupt sides as well. So let's say they have a resource that they're getting ready to use to claim the battlefield and it goes back to you. You can just disrupt that resource and then they won't be able to claim the battlefield unless they somehow get other resources like discard for a reroll, hoping to get a resource side so they can resolve that and then get that resource to spend to claim the battlefield. I also really like that he has a discard side, so it makes him another target for Commando Raid. So Commando Raid will work on him, Akbar, Launch Bay, things like that. So it's nice to get more options for that card, because it does have to be a red card, a red die with a discard face. So one thing negative about him is his health is very low, so he's probably going to get attacked very, very early. Especially if, you know, your opponent doesn't want to continually spend the resource every time they want to claim the battlefield. So we're going to get rid of him so they don't have to spend that resource to get the battlefield. He's going to pair with a lot of people because he only costs 12 points. So you can pair him with quite a few characters. You can pair him with an elite Han Solo if you wanted. So like elite Han Solo, elite Snap, and just have a lot of control. I like that he has like those 2 disrupt sides. He also has that discard as well. So he's going to be an interesting character. I'm not sure if I'm going to, if I get him, I'm going to try to play him, but I'm not going to go out of my way to probably get a Snap Wexley die or 2 Snap Wexley dice. But I think he has some pretty cool abilities, and I really like his die as well. He doesn't really have to do a lot of damage, But, you know, you can always throw guns on him as well to get him to do a little bit more damage. We're going to move into our next card. All right, next up we have the A180 Blaster. Red hero, costs 3 resources, has 2 range damage, plus 2 range damage, a disrupt, 2 specials, and the blank. And the special actually has 3 options you can use. So if you resolve the special, you get to choose from these options. You can deal 1 damage to a character, then give that the attached character a shield. You can deal 1 damage to each of an opponent's characters, or you can deal 2 unblockable damage to a character. I really like the specials on this. I think they're pretty interesting, especially they're very situational. So if you really need a character to survive a little bit longer, you can deal 1 damage and get a shield on that character. If your opponent has multiple characters left, you can hit all of them for 1. You can do 2 unblockable damage to a single character. I think it's, you know, very situational. So I do like the fact that whatever the situation is, you can kind of tailor the special to the situation. I think the cost is a little bit high, because this is the same cost as the IQA-11, and that actually has stronger sides. Granted, it only has 1 special, and that special is the same as the 3rd special here, which is deal 2 unblockable damage to a character. I'm not sure if I'm going to go out of my way to play this card. I think it's interesting that it has those 3 specials, but I think the damage sides, the normal 2 range damage, the normal and the plus 2 are a little bit weak. But we'll see how this plays out once the set comes out. We'll move into the next card. Alright, next up we have Astromech, neutral red support. It costs 2 resources. Has a single focus, a 2 focus, a shield, a resource, and 2 blanks. And as an action, you can remove this die to turn a vehicle die to any side. That is going to be huge, especially if people start including this in Django and Veers decks. So you're going to run Astromech with Slave 1. So let's say you roll out your Astromech and you roll blank. You can, as the action, remove Astromech to put Slave 1 on its special or something like that, or put it on its 4 damage side. You can use it with a Millennium Falcon and put it on its discard or damage side. Same thing with the AT-ST. I also like that it has the 2 focus sides as well. So even if you don't remove the die, you can still focus into the special on Slave 1 or whatever else on any vehicle that you want or any other die. But I do like that it has an option if you roll badly, or if you really just need Slave 1 to be on its special, you can just remove it and put it at put Slave 1 on its special. So that's Astromech, neutral red. I can see this, like I said, playing into Django and Veers decks, especially if those decks start including Slave 1. We're going to move into our next card. Okay, next we have Loose Ends, Yellow Villain Event. 2 resources, has ambush, so you get to take another action after you play it. Remove 1 of your dice showing range damage to discard the top 4 cards of an opponent's deck. This is going to go really well in yellow villain mill decks, or yellow red, yellow blue, whatever it might be. I think this card is going to go well with the deck that's kind of going around now, which is Jabba and 2 Night Sisters, so elite Jabba, 2 Night Sisters. So let's say you roll a Night Sister out on her range damage side, you then play this, remove 1 of your Night Sister's range damage to mill 4 cards. And then Jabba all has like his own mill sides as well. And you then can keep manipulating stuff with the other Night Sister, doing rerolls and stuff like that. Especially if you remove, let's say you rolled out some range dice and you rolled modified sides. The modified sides you won't be able to resolve on their own anyway, so you can remove 1 of those, pay 2 resources, and then mill 4 cards. I think this card is going to be really cool in those kind of decks, especially like Jabba Vader or Jabba and Night Sisters. Pretty cool card right here. I really like the fact that it mills 4, and then if you run 2 copies, you can essentially burn through almost a quarter of somebody's deck by playing 2 of these, because you're going to mill 4 cards each time, you're milling 8. That's, of course, if you have the range damage to remove to do that. So that is the downside, is that you do have to remove a range damage die, but I like that you can remove a die that you wouldn't be able to resolve anyway, like a plus 2 range damage or something like that. So that's Loose Ends. I think that's pretty cool. We're going to move into our next card. Next up, we have Decisive Blow. It's a blue neutral event, so you can use it in hero and villain decks. 3 resources. Resolve 1 of your dice showing melee damage, Then remove all character and upgrade dice of the character you just dealt damage to. This is insane. It does cost 3, so it's pretty expensive, but the fact that you can basically pay 3 resources, get damage out of it, and remove all of a character's dice and upgrade dice is really insane. I imagine using this, let's say Django and like Veers have rolled out, and you're playing, let's say you're playing Kylo. I'm just going with Kylo because he's on the artwork here. But you're playing as Kylo Dooku. Can pay 3 resources, resolve, let's say, like a 2 melee side on Django, and remove both Django dice and all the equipment that he's carrying on him. That's really awesome. I mean, it might mean that your opponent gets to claim the battlefield that round because you just removed a ton of their dice, but that's more damage for you to deal out if you have like multiple characters that you can resolve. And it means that they're not going to be able to really use that character. You're not going to be able to use that character at all that round, especially if you do it fairly early. If they've rolled out Django as a response to something, and you just turn around and decisive blow, do damage to Django, and pull out all his dice. Let's say they were waiting to get Veers out to do more damage. This card is, I think it's very fairly costed. I think 3 is pretty good for essentially what you can do, because you're, like I said, you're getting damage and you're removing a bunch of dice. That's Decisive Blow. We're going to move into our next card. Next up, we have New Orders. Cost 2 resources, a neutral gray event, so it can go in any deck. Switch to battlefield with a battlefield that is not being used but was brought to the game and use its claim ability. This is really cool. I like the fact that you not only get to switch to battlefield, but you get the ability of whatever the new battlefield is. So, one thing I can think of doing with this is, essentially, this can really slow down Hyperloop decks. So, if they're on the Emperor's Throne Room, they have their Millennium Falcon out, all they really do is they roll out Falcon, they pass it to you, you do something, they claim the Emperor's Throne Room, resolving the Falcon Special, and Hyperlooping. This lets you switch out the battlefield, and you get the ability of it too. So, if you switch out to a battlefield, let's say that's not the Emperor's Throne Room, they can still get back to the Throne Room if they play another hyperspace jump, but they're going to have to roll the Falcon and have it land on its special, or focus into the special on the Falcon, to then get that hyperspace jump back from their discard pile so they can play it again. They're not just going to be able to claim, do that, play it out of discard, and loop back to the starting location. So New Orders is really cool. I think it's going to be a way to kind of like really break Hyperloop. And I like that it costs 2, and I like that you get the effect of the battlefield as well, and that it's neutral. So it can go in any deck, hero or villain. New Orders is going to be really cool. I really like it. We're going to move into our next card. Next up, we have Fast Hands. 0 cost yellow upgrade. It's neutral, so it can go in hero or villain decks. After you activate attached character, you may resolve one of its character or upgrade dice. So this gives a single die, essentially a Django-like effect. So you can roll it and immediately resolve one of them. Imagine this on Rey with Force Speed. You roll out Rey, hit the special on Force Speed, resolve it, take two more actions. So it's going to go very well in certain decks. I don't think it's going to go very well with Django, because Django can essentially almost do this already. So it basically gives other characters an ability that's similar to Django. So if you had this on Django and you rolled as a response, you could immediately resolve one of the dice. But since Django's ability goes off on your opponent's turn, and then so they roll a character, you activate Django, it passes to you, you can then just start resolving stuff. So I don't think this is going to go well on Django, but it's going to go well on a lot of other characters, especially if they want to, like, you know, like, hit right away. It's like, if I roll well, and I'm showing, let's say, like, a 2 range damage on something, I want to have this on there so I can resolve it right away so it doesn't get, like, electroshocked, or he doesn't like you, or just, like, force thrown, that kind of thing. It's going to prevent a lot of that from happening, so if I roll well, my opponent has Force Throw, they can just throw that damage back at me. With this, it'll allow me to resolve that die right away, and without having to risk it being, like, removed or Force Thrown, or where I take damage from my own die. So that's Fast Hands. I think that this one's pretty cool. I like that it's a zero cost as well, so you can play it. If you play it on Rey, you can roll her out right away and then resolve right away as well. So I think this is going to go really well in Han Rey decks as well. So we're going to move into our next card. And the final card we're going to discuss is Ewok Village on Endor. It's a new battlefield. Has a claim effect of remove all shields from a character. I think this is going to be a very situational battlefield. I don't see myself probably ever running it. Some decks that will work well against, though, are like Han and Rey decks. So if Han is constantly getting shielded from ambush, this will get rid of those shields. It'll work well against Qui-Gon, so he won't be able to use his ability, at least not until he gets more shields on him. And it could also potentially work well against Dooku, especially if he's shielded up and is discarding to get shields. This will, you know, remove all those shields. However, if you're running a shield removal deck, I think you're probably going to be running like TIE Fighters and Intimidates anyway, or other stuff that just consistently does damage. So if you're consistently doing good amounts of damage, I think this battlefield would be kind of useless for you. Because let's say if you're doing good amounts of damage, and by the time you go to claim the battlefield, your opponents might not have any shields on them anyway. So I can only see this really working in a few situations, like I said, with Han and Rey, Qui-Gon, and maybe Dooku playing against those decks. Otherwise, I don't really think this is going to be a great battlefield. I probably won't run it. But that's the final card from today. We'll leave links in the description to where you can check out all the articles from where these cards were spoiled from. As always, remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I want to thank you again for watching, and take care.